off.
Okay, now we're fixing to go on. Gretchen and I are going on our morning walk. I'll try to pan in and show her. She's ready to go down the stairs. And we're going to be crossing that street there. We're going to go down my front stairs and down my front sidewalk. We're going to turn to the left, go to the intersection, and cross. So, Gretchen, forward. Good girl. It's kind of cold out here today for March. Now we're going to go to the left, Gretchen. Left. Good girl. Good girl. We're going to get up here to the corner, and this is a two-way intersection, meaning that it has a stop sign. Sounds kind of quiet to me. Here comes a car this way. Okay, Gretchen, let's line up. Line up here. Okay. I think your car's coming over there. We're lined up. A parallel traffic has to stop with stop signs. And I'm having to listen. Here comes a car. It's turning. I can hear it's turning, but I didn't know that as it was speeding down the hill. Gretchen, forward. I can hear that. Another car's coming that way. Another car's coming that way. And Gretchen is taking us forward. And when we get across this street here, she gets a nice little petting. Good girl, Gretchen. You did a great job. You did a great job crossing the street. Now we're gonna go forward. We're gonna pick up our pace because this is our nice morning walk. This side of the street, she doesn't tend to pick up her pace too well. Come on, Gretchen, let's hop up. See how fast she can go. This side of the street, she tends to go a little bit slower. Maybe because she's getting started, I'm not sure. But this is just our neighborhood. Pretty easy walking. Pretty nice out here today, too. Gretchen had a big, big time last night. She went to a party with lots of music. And it was loud, live music. With lots of refreshments that she had to avoid. And of course, I took along her dinner with her so she could eat at her regular time. And it was in an old antebellum home. So we went out on the back porch where there was a nice rocking chair in the western sunset, and it was nice and warm out there outside of the wind. She had a great time. And of course, she was the belle of the ball. She was wearing she's a black full-bred German Shepherd with mostly black all over her body. She's pretty much long hair for a Shepherd. And then her legs are creamish white color, all evenly marked. Her chest is white, and she's got beautiful markings on her face with a gorgeous Shepherd mask. Now, she's one of the Shepherds that, I don't know if you can... If you're sighted and you're looking at this, you might be able to see. Now I'm holding my harness properly. She's got no saddle, as they call it in markings for German Shepherds. Gretchen, you did very good with that dog distraction, ignoring it. That was good. Very cool. See if I can paint over on her. See if I can paint on her walking. Doing a good job, Gretchen. It's just a nice neighborhood. Now I can't see any of the neighborhood, but when I was a child, and I had better vision, still legally blind, but I had good mobility vision, and I had very good spatial perception for someone who had some very unusual eye, conditions. I wasn't able to see print, but I could certainly see to walk around independently. And I walked up and down these sidewalks because my grandparents lived in the same house that I live in. And so I went to a primary and elementary school right up here. And on special days, you know, when my parents weren't available, my mom, I would walk home to my grandparents' house and my aunt's house. There's the school. It's a historic school, built in, I believe, 1901. My father went to that school first through eighth grade, and I went to that school first through third grade. So there are kids over there playing, I can hear them. There's a three-way stop here, and that's really confusing. Gretchen and I don't have to go on the three-way stop. Several years ago, I picked up my granddaughter from this school every single afternoon because I was a grandmama, and that's what grandmamas do. And I came by myself every day with my cane. This is before I got Gretchen, and found my way across the intersection to the school and waited for Elizabeth, my granddaughter, and then we would walk home together. Now Gretchen is picking up the pace, which is pretty cool. Not sure if it's because she's seeing the kids across the street. This is cool. I like the way she walks. She's very fast. I'm going to try to focus in on her again. Good, Gretchen. Leave it. Good girl. And she's taught, you know, not to pay attention to the distractions. She did pretty good. Good, Gretchen. That was very good. Because she could actually stop it. You got to be very careful right here. These truncated bumps are all lifted up. I've reported it just verbally in passing, but I have to turn in a requisition and ask the city to correct those, because those are very, very dangerous, not only for Gretchen and myself, but for anybody that's passing that corner. And now I'm going to see if I can get an idea of how fast she's walking. I really like to walk fast this street, and I really don't have my fast walking shoes on. This is just kind of an open sidewalk where there's not any encumbrances. There's nothing here that really, you know, encroaches on our space. And it gets wider up here because there's a lot of church traffic on the weekends and a lot of pedestrians. So they've widened the sidewalk a little bit up here, which is nice for everybody. I wish most sidewalks were like that, but really the standard is, I think, around 36 inches, especially for the older sidewalks in this town, or in any town. 36 inches is about standard. Gretchen loves this walk, because she knows it by heart. Now she's very curious. She keeps peeking around her left shoulder for some reason. I feel her harness turning. I've got my hand properly positioned on her harness, her leash. And we're just walking. We're on the third leg of a four-sided block. And when we get to the corner of this third leg, we make a decision. And sometimes I let Gretchen make the decision because it doesn't matter to me. Both situations take us back to our home. The first decision she would make is, do we want to cross at the four stop sign intersection, meaning each street has a stop sign. Now, where we came out and we just videoed, only two sides have a stop sign. So we practice both every day. Doesn't matter to me which one she practices, because they're both equally difficult or equally easy, whichever way you want to look at it. If there's a whole lot of traffic, you know, they're difficult or easy. I tend to like a lot of traffic because that lets me know what's coming and what isn't. And there's a beeping sound that's not sure what it is. Certainly is not distracting her. This pup doesn't get distracted very easily, and that is just awesome. That's some activity, I think, going over across the street from the church. Okay, here we are at our truncated bumps that indicate that we're in an intersection. It's a four-way stop. We're fixing to go forward, Gretchen, because we know this car has to stop forward. Good girl. Good girl. We know that car had to stop anyway. May as well go. And now she's like, oh, goodness. Look at you, girl. She's a girl on a mission. We're on the fourth leg of our square. We happen to have already crossed the street, so that means we're on our side of the street where our house is. So, I'm blind, and I think that Gretchen could actually do this, leg here blindfolded, because this is the very first leg that we started on. When I first got her 4 months ago, we came out my front door, went down to this corner, didn't cross. It was too daunting at that point. She needed to learn increments. So I walked her all the way down to the block, showed her street. Because this street here belongs to Gretchen. At least she thinks it does. The sidewalk does. We meet lots of friends on the sidewalk, people we don't know. Some people we do know, some neighbors. But some people we don't know, and everybody's so friendly. And I've not had any difficulty with people wanting to interact with Gretchen and not interacting with me. We were trained on how to address those kinds of situations because Gretchen's working and she doesn't need to be interacted with. And I've had people talk to me about her in her presence. Here we are. Good girl. Right to our front steps. Good job, Gretchen. Good job, girl. You did an awesome job.